experience of catching a mouse.
Mouse.
You know, one of those
little animals
of the box.
Yeah.
It has a trap door. May I ask, how big was the mouse that you bought? What did you do about it?
Drowned it.
Yeah. I've had this experience in Bangalore. When I came in here, my wife told me there's a mouse coming into our kitchen. And I had to firstly get a trap, place it there, and then find out what. And then in the morning, I didn't know what to do about it. But I've had a different experience. I've caught not just mouse. You wouldn't believe it, I've actually caught a live tiger, a man-eating tiger, accurately a woman-eating tiger. This was during my stint as a manager in the TSA, where we had a man-eating tiger. Man of Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters, welcome guests.
Good evening.
When I was thinking about introducing myself, like Man of Toastmasters said, I had to cover a nice long day. So I thought the way I'll do it is in the form of some snippets. Early childhood, maybe I was around 10 years old, December 1971, sitting in a trench, freshly dug out in my neighbor's yard. My sister was with me, my mother was with me as well. We were sitting there in the trench, looking out at the glowing sight of a B-57 bomber jet, Pakistani jet. Pakistan had declared war on India, and as you may guess, I was living at an Air Force station. This was in Agra, the city famous for Taj Mahal. Looking up there, it was moonlit night, glowing with not just the moon and the starlight, but also with the firing of the anti-aircraft guns. My father was in the Air Force. He was an ace pilot, highly decorated. Before this, he used to be a freedom fighter, fighting alongside Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. So it came upon me as an expectation that will I fall on his Christmas. I couldn't really decide. I couldn't really make up my mind. So I drifted to school. My father was posted abroad. I had the opportunity of meeting, you know, fairly famous personalities from the Indian Foreign Service. So I thought I should join the IAS. But that's a great opportunity for me to now go and see the world. I could make up my mind. I came to Bangalore, and my grandfather, who had a I stayed with him, and he had a major influence in my life. He was a man full of verve, full of energy, and never gave up. And he suggested, probably looking at my confusion, maybe I should try commerce, I should try chartered accountancy. So I followed what he said, and I joined St. Joseph's College. But that's when I came to somewhere where I felt quickly, you know, what on earth am I doing? So I answered an ad in the Times of India to join Bookworm Plantations. Bookworm Plantations was a part of Unilever Group eventually, and I was to end up serving there for 23 years. Something of my family. My wife, Indira, is a talented teacher of young children. And she actually got a rather good shock when we were to get married, because I told her that I work on the TSA in Madurai district. But 8 days before I got married, I got transferred to Assam. You wouldn't believe it, it was the northeasternmost part of the state of Assam, a place called Dumduma, otherwise known as Assam. And she didn't have a choice. We were already in a relationship. We got married. We just finished 25 years. My children, which is the reason why I joined Toastmasters, apart from my wife finding me a real bore, the way I speak. My older daughter, Akshita, she's a freshly minted lawyer. My younger one is a budding chef, studying in Bombay at the Hotel Management Institute. Well, I joined Toastmasters to lead by example, and it looks like now they have joined the speech conference. So something's working. Back at work, I discovered a couple of strengths about myself. One was that when I interacted with people, I seemed to have a kind of calming effect on me. So my employer seemed to recognize this. And I moved into HR. I got an opportunity with my company to move into HR. So that is how, after about 10 years of working in a tea plantation, I've spent the remaining 18 years, close to 20 years, working in HR. I'll end with a good story where I am today. I still get these episodes of what on earth am I doing? So maybe the story might reflect what I am searching for. They say that a master was asked by his disciple, what is it that you, what has changed for you ever since you found the place? So the master says, every morning when I wake up, I am struck by the realization that I may not live till the night. And I hold this realization right from the beginning. Is that all? I mean, we are sitting here at your feet to learn from you, and you're telling us a fact that you are definitely good at this. Master said, we know this as a fact, but do you know it in your heart as a living truth? You may know the facts of your mind, for instance, but is it the same as thinking? You may know about the facts of life, but is it the same as living it?
Objectives of Project CC10 are to inspire the audience by appealing to noble motives and challenging the audience to achieve a higher level of beliefs or achievements. Appealing to the audience needs and emotions using stories, anecdotes, and quotes to add drama. Avoid losing notes. And please note, the time is 8 to 10 minutes.
Please help me welcome Godfrey Sons presenting the CC10. Will you please welcome?